the show. Hi, my name is Layla, and I will be reading a monologue from The Woman from Almost Maine. I know this isn't going to be very easy, but I was just so scared because I was out there all alone in the world, and I just kept thinking how I had no place in this world, but I realized I did have a place in this world, and I was here with you, so I flew, I took a plane to come see you, I took a taxi, and I just, thank God you're here. Wait, you're not who I thought you'd be. This is the house. I'm so sorry. I'm looking for Daniel Harding. Does Daniel Harding live here? I thought he did. I mean, he doesn't. Does he? I'm so sorry. This is so embarrassing. I mean, who is this woman and what is she doing here? You wouldn't happen to know him, would you? Big guy, big tall guy, played basketball all night center? No? Played hockey, too? Don't answer. It's a horrible question to ask someone who lives in a small town. It's if everybody in small town says everybody else. I mean, you know who you know and you don't know who you don't know. I'm sorry. Again, he lived here, stayed here, I thought. I mean, he was one of the ones who stayed. I didn't stay. I went away. And I'm starting to think he did too.
My name is Farah, and I'm going to be doing Draco from Harry Potter.
Woo!
So it's true then, Harry Potter is coming to Hogwarts. This is Crabbe and this is Goyle, and I'm Malfoy, Draco Malfoy. Oh, you think my name's funny, do you? Well, no need to ask yours. Red hair and a hand-me-down robe? You must be a Weasley. You'll soon find out some wizarding families are better than others, Potter. You don't want to be making friends with the wrong sort. I can help you there.
Hi, my name is Lucy, and I'm going to be doing JoJo from Seussical and a fairy godmother from The Descendants.
Now that is a very unusual hat. I wonder what's under a hat such as that. It could be a creature they call a gazette, who balances things on his head because it's flat. Or a stripe-loving pipester from Upper Mount Bat. Or sort of a kind of a hat-wearing cat. Are you a very large think or a genuine cat? I can't say I've ever met a cat in a hat.
Welcome to Ordon Prep. I'm Fairy Godmother, your headmistress. Hush, Chad. Now, just because spells are possible doesn't mean they are legal. There is to be no magic on these premises. We find our magic in expanding our minds. Clear? Well, back to it. This coronation won't schedule itself. Welcome once again. This will be quite the education for us all.
Grace, and I'm going to be reciting Woman from Almost Maine. I know this isn't going to be very easy, but I was just so alone there out in the world, and I just got scared because I realized I had no place in this world. But then just out of nowhere, I just remembered that I did have a place in this world, and that was with you. So I flew a plane, and I took a taxi to get to you. Thank God you're... Oh, wait. You're not the person who I thought you'd be. Sorry, does Daniel Harding live here? I'm looking for Daniel Harding. He doesn't, does he? I'm so sorry. I'm so embarrassed. Who is this woman and what is she doing here? You know him? Big guy, big tall guy, played basketball all main center. He played hockey too. Oh, don't even answer that. That was a horrible question to ask somebody who lives in a small town. It's just like people in small towns knows everybody else. You know who you know, and you don't know who you don't know. Just like anywhere else. Well, I'm so sorry to have bothered you. I heard he lived here, but he stayed here. He was one of the ones who stayed. I didn't stay. I went away. I guess he did too.
Hi, my name is Skylar, and I'll be doing Sour Kangaroo from Seasicle. Why, that speck is as small as the head of a pin. A person on that way there has never been. You're the biggest brave fool in the jungle of Noah, and I don't care who to tell. Maybe I'm nasty, maybe I'm cruel, but you're the biggest brave fool in the jungle of Noah. Elephants ate 2 swifts as a rule, and that horn is just a great big gray fool.
From Undertale Deltarune.
Hey there, it's been a while, huh? Queen Torhas came out of the ruins and is now ruling over the underground. She's in a new policy. All humans who fall down here will not be treated as enemies, but as friends. It's probably best for all of us anyway. As for King Asgore, not so much. You see, all the treasures that you can maybe call souls just escaped out of nowhere. So, yeah, we don't know what we're gonna do. Most of the monsters have given up hope of reaching the surface, but some of us haven't. And hey, if we don't give up hope, don't give up hope anywhere, okay? But who knows how long we'll take to get out of here. But we're gonna get off here eventually. That's a promise.
Hello, my name is Lizzie, and I will be doing Donkey from Shrek. Can I say, that was amazing? Man, they were tripping all over themselves trying to get away from you. Say, you lost at something? Oh, you're trying to figure out the best road to the clue. I know the clue. You gotta let me take you there because I'm like a GPS with fair. Come on, nobody's fine on their own. Not when they look like we do. By the way, I don't know if I mentioned this already, but I did 6 years in solitary for impersonating a piñata.
My name is Maya, and I will be doing Danny from Cats Don't Dance. Because you can't forget the feeling, can you? The feeling when you two dance together, when you play, when you sing. They've cursed you, humiliated you, and even slammed the door in your face. But they still haven't made you forget, have they?
Hi, my name is Paige, and I'm going to be Sally from Your Good Man, Charlie Brown.
A C? A C? How could anyone get a C on a coat hanger sculpture?
May I ask a question?
Was I graded on the sculpture itself?
If so, isn't it true that time alone can judge a great work of art? Or was I judged on my talent? If so, is it fair to be judged over part of my life which I have no control? If I was graded on my effort, then I was graded unfairly. For I tried my hardest. Or was I graded on what I had learned? If so, then you are not my teacher, also being judged on your ability to transmit knowledge to me. Are you willing to share my seat?
I'm London, and I'm going to read Kim from Absence of Gray Matter.
My name is Kim Cutledge, and I am broken. I'm not really broken in the way that a tree becomes broken during a tropical storm, or the way an egg becomes broken when it is dropped to the kitchen floor. I'm broken like a bone, painfully, and somewhat grotesque to look at. What I mean to say is, I'm a poet. Really, I am. Listen to this, it's a love poem. Excuse me, but if you would, give me the chance, I think I could do what I need to make you feel good. What? No applause? Now you see what I mean. Broken. I was even blessed with being tortured. Poe and Dante were tortured. I am simply ineffectual and unloved. And you must be thinking, surely you jest. Who would not love you? The answer is the source of my pain, the reason I cannot heal. I do not love me. On the plus side, nothing is ever my fault. I can always point a finger at someone else. On the downside, I talk to myself a lot. Like now, for example, none of you are real. And I kind of hate to break it to you, because I'm sure you think you're real, but I made every one of you up. But you want to know the worst part? Would Keanu Reeves please stand up? See, he's not here. He's never here. I'm so broken that I can't even control my own hallucinations, even after I've accepted the fact that they're hallucinations.
Father usually pays, so my dad didn't want it in my third marriage. There I'd be in my cupcake dress, all ready to trip down the aisle. But then he would whisper these words of advice in my ear. Don't worry, doll, I know a good lawyer. All right, Rosie, let's see what you're wearing to the wedding. You're joking, right? Are you trying to make some sort of statement on tyranny of wedlock? Who cares anyway? We're no closer to solving the murder mysteries or unearthing the secrets or unearthing the evidence against us. I found you lurking conspicuously in the conservatory, honestly. And then the secret passage to the lounge has scarlet flowers. Scarlet flowers usually have 5 petals, but this one had 4, meaning you already plucked one when you murdered the motorist with a wrench and then shot the singing telegram girl before she could finish her sentence. I bet she was an old patient of yours or something. I wonder what kind of dirt she had on you. Wait, we can all rush him. He's got no more bullets left in the gun. There was one for Mr. Body in the study, 2 for the cat, 2 for the lounge door, and 1 for the singing telegram. 1 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1.
From Silent Sky. I just wonder why you see so much expectation in everything except his family. Even so, Daddy is so proud. You think he isn't. You think he resists your great escape. You really know. You also really know that I made you up for him. Because you never wrote or came home. I wrote letters for you, went into the house every week, went into the whole family, so happy and thrilled. Oh, Daddy, look what we got from Herta today. She said she loves you and thanked you on and on. What a comforting fiction.
It's all the rage. with the French and Brits. Transylvania mania. In the chest, the Algonquin wits.
It's the way wars that never quits.
It's the pot we cost with an ice.